starting the research and, you know, getting the first customers and users before you even start coding also helps you to work on the MVP. So then when you talk with that users, when you have already the user base, that you should, of course, reach out on a regular basis, send updates, and also ask them for feedback. That's super valuable to build the MVP that people will actually use and will actually like.
Hi, everyone. It's our next episode of SaaS and Tech Interviews. And today we're talking to Janek Novak. Janek is the founder at a company called Botwise. Hi, Janek. How are you doing today?
Hi. Thank you for having me here. I'm great. Thanks.
Thank you for your time. Well, Janek, if you could tell us in one sentence, what is Botwise, what does it serve to, how would you describe it?
All right. So Botwise is a dedicated knowledge base for customer service. So we started as a corporate search, but we are now more focused on the customer service, where that speed of accessing the information when the customer is waiting on the line or waiting on the live chat or in the physical shop is the most important.
Cool. Thank you. Well, we've chosen a topic, how to find a product market fit. I guess it's crucial and very important. And the choice of the topic is not a coincidence. So, Janek, could you tell us why the choice of the topic?
All right. So the topic is very close to us, I think, because we've been struggling with that a little bit longer, I think, than usual. Or maybe it's just because of the marketing of the super successful startup. They just, like, you know, in 1 year they can start and get to the first million. So we've been doing this for a while, trying and experimenting, and that's why I really think that this is something that I would like to discuss and tell a little bit more how it actually looks from the small perspective startup that we are still bootstrapping, because that was our choice. So we don't have the investors, so we were focused on getting there, but we are not in that very hurry.
I guess, cool. Well, I couldn't agree more. Sure. So the first question, what comes first, chicken or egg? So do you choose the right market for your product, or you adjust your product to the needs of market?
So I think it can work both ways. So in our case, it was a super coincidence that we're doing what we're doing. Mm-hmm. Because we attended the hackathon organized by the bank. And it was very nice, actually, because we met a lot of people from that bank that came with their needs and ideas. Yeah. And we talked with a few people and decided that, hey, let's build a chatbot that will support the customer service teams to answer questions from the clients much faster. So we were not the customer service experts. We were not people from the bank. So that was the pure coincidence that we were interested in AI. We knew how to build the software. So this started, and the market somehow appeared. And that was actually a good starting point, because we already had the need, the customer. So we thought, okay, if that one person in that one of the biggest banks wants it, it's probably that everyone else from the similar profile will be happy to have it.
So in your case, let's say it started more with the market. So you saw a need and you just said, why not? Why not help us this way?
Exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
Perfect. And as I understand, you'll speak from your own experience. So does Botwise is in the right place? What makes you think so? And what are indicators? You know, how do you understand that you're doing something right? Or how do you understand that you're in the wrong place?
So we're definitely not in the right place. So we don't have this strictly product market fit just struggling with scaling up. We're still, I think, at some point to still looking for this right product market fit. Mm-hmm. Our road from the beginning was different, and we didn't pivot as quickly as we should have. Mm-hmm. So that's definitely our lessons learned. So as I mentioned before, we started as a kind of a chatbot for the customer service teams. Mm-hmm. So they can, you know, upload their documents and ask the chatbot and retrieve the answers quickly from those documents.
Yes.
But on the way, we even though we successfully did this proof of concept in the implementation for the bank, we got the very nice numbers. We reduced the average handling time by 7%. Mm-hmm. So for 400 agents, that's actually a lot. But after that, we struggled to get another customers with the similar profile, with the similar needs, and also with the priorities in that area. So they were more focused on the automation, about some other stuff. And I think that it took us too much time to actually notice that, that this is nice, but probably we're not in the right place with the timing. They still have different priorities earlier, so they need still need to first solve the, their more basic needs. So, but we're still like, you know, struggling and but still doing the same, right? Because we thought, okay, that one person, that, that maybe not that one person, but that web bank had that need, so we're sure that everyone else have the same problems. And it took us too much time to realize that it's more like nice to have, at least for that time that we were doing this, and that was like a few two, 3 years ago, and that's definitely our lessons learned, that we should pivot much faster. And now, and then we went into the corporate search, so decided that hey, everyone has a multiple sources of information, right? We have SharePoint, Dropbox, Drive, Slack, emails, and everyone that works in the today's company is browsing through all those applications every day and look for the answer. So the need was pretty clear. And everyone was excited that when they heard the idea, and I want to do it. But we had the problem. We encountered the problem in a different place. So we encountered the problem with the implementation, with the security, with connecting different systems in the organization, which was a lot of risk, a lot of paperwork, a lot of compliance work, a lot of API setups, and those kind of things. So even though it appears like a good idea for everyone, but when it comes to the implementation, it appeared to be too hard to do, especially with our strictly limited resources, as we still were not pursuing the VCs actively at that time and wanted to bootstrap. So, you know, you might have the product market fit and get excited, like maybe it's not still the product market fit, right? Because at some point you have the excited users, but for the implementation it's really hard or almost impossible. So the product market fit is really not there, right? And then we move from that. Also, it took us too much time to realize that this is probably not the easiest way and not the solution that we should pursue. And now for the last few months, we're like focused on the dedicated knowledge base for customer service.
Well, it sounds like for several years you've been through a lot of pivoting, like constant and constant changes.
Yes, kind of, but still it sounds like that, but it didn't, it took us too much time, and we should have done this much quicker and experiment much more that we did.
I see. Well, how would you describe your journey of searching for the best product fit? Did you do some research? Did you do iterations, or just use your, gut feeling? Where did you start from, and what were your steps, let's say?
All right. So first, we were focused on the working with that bank, and that was our like 100% commitment to build a solution that they will be happy about. I think that was kind of okay at the beginning, and few months later, that's after we started working on the development, we also started looking for another customer, so another potential client, another potential users that might be interested. So that's very important for every startup not to get too excited about one customer, even if this is like the big known company, and still validate the idea with other customers, right? Because we might overfit the product to that one particular bank or that company, or that one particular company might be an exception, right, on the market. So it's really important that almost from the first day you start to code, you also validate the idea with other people on the market, other potential users, other potential companies, to make sure that you have the broader audience and not only, a small number of companies.
I see. And could you give 1, 2, 3 steps map for, let's say, people who are currently in trouble with finding a product market fit?
All right. So today we would probably even start a little bit differently. So first we would start with actually creating the landing page and doing some campaign mm-hmm. to see if we actually have the traction before even starting to code anything. And I think most of the founders, more experienced founders, are exactly doing this way. Mm-hmm. So first they are building a landing page, doing some surveys, research on the market before they start to build something. So that's very important. And starting the research and, you know, getting the first customers and users before you even start coding also helps you to work on the MVP. So then when you talk with that users, when you have already the user base, that you should of course reach out on a regular basis, send updates and also ask them for feedback. Mm-hmm. That's super valuable to build the MVP that people will actually use and will actually like. So it's not the other way. So don't code, don't, you know, go to the basement with your developers teams, even though they really like it, and sit like for the whole year, and then go out to the market and show if this is actually something that people need. So do exactly the other way. So first, don't call and do the market research. So that's the most important part. The second is when you launch the MVP, already talk with as many users and customers as you can. And we actually like kind of doing like a whole set of different exercises to see what's happening in our app. So we organize a regular interviews with our users. Mm-hmm. So when we onboard a new account, because we usually have like, you know, one company, and this one company can have like 40, 60, 100 different agents. Mm-hmm. So we are onboarding one company, but at the same time onboarding like 40 different people. Mm-hmm. So we talk with those people as much as we can. So after like, you know, some time, if we already built some good relationships, just reach to the manager, to our people, and ask them to, hey, can we, you know, call with other people and see what they actually think. That's a very interesting feedback we get. And we also not only do the interviews, but also we do the surveys. We also use the mixed panel to, you know, to see how much time they spend on the app and what features they use. Mm-hmm. Because they might say that, hey, we love Botwise, we use it a lot, it's very useful, and at the same time we see they are not actually using that much, and then we can actually, hey, something's not wrong, probably manager okay. told them that Botwise is great and they should be happy, and they are not actually. Mm-hmm. So it's very important to do all those activities at the same time, right? So not only interviews, also surveys, also tracking events in the app, to actually make sure that we have all the data that we need. Okay, so I might say, so the last step, right? Because the first one was to get feedback early before you build. Mm-hmm. Then if you build and launch, get the feedback on a regular basis as much as you can from your users in a different way. Mm-hmm. And the third could be actually prioritizing it in the proper way. Mm-hmm. Because for some users, this might be the most important thing, right? So analytics for my people are the most important. For other users, creating the articles and templates might be something more needed. Or for other users, creating workflows that will guide agents for the most complex processes might be something that they need. So when you have a lot of feedback and you talk with a lot of people, you have a lot of ideas, and exactly. Everyone has something else.
Exactly.
So then it's really important to actually make the right call and work on the features that are actually the most useful for the biggest group of your users.
Cool. So then how to deal with ever-changing times? So let's say today you found your product market fit and everything works well. Something has changed, and again you have to change. So how to deal with the situation that is ever-changing?
So probably do the things I said on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. So it's really important to talk with your users all the time and with the same users all the time also, right? So not only with the new users that you're onboarding, mm-hmm. but also go back to the old users, to the old cohorts of users, and also talk with them. And hey, you started using Botwise like a year ago. Is it better now that it was a year ago? Do you see a big difference or does a small difference, right? Mm-hmm. So it's like, then it's really important to see, right? So to be in a constant, let's say, conversation with all the users and take into account the needs of the new users, because there are probably some people like coming and, you know, we need to grow your customer base, but you need to make sure that the current users are not going somewhere else. So the retention is the most, I think, important SaaS metric, and that you want to track it closely.
So you cannot actually dwell on the achieved success. It's a constant improvement.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, so let's move to our rapid fire round. Your biggest regret?
My biggest regret that we didn't keep up quicker.
I see. What is your business hero? Who is your business hero?
Probably Elon Musk. I think this is the question, the answer for a lot of people, but this guy is really exceptional and I think this is his.
I see. Well, you recently became a father. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Give one survival advice for future dads.
Be patient. And that's the most important one. Patient and consistent. So this is probably also very, very important for the startup and business. The consistency is the most important part, in my opinion. So it's not working very hard because you will get burned out quickly, mm-hmm. and you will have enough after a few mistakes and not having a success for a while. But having the consistency and not maybe working that hard, but be consistent, mm-hmm. is the key for success, in my opinion.
That's how you find something in common in parenting and
exactly.
in startup. Okay, I see.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Janek, for your interview, and thank you for your time. Thank you for your opinions and your expertise. Well, thank you very much and have a great day.
Yeah, thank you. Have a great day.
Bye.
Bye.